वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू वन एंड ऑल प्रेजेंट हियर ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स गवर्नमेंट दिग्विजय पीजी कॉलेज राजनांदगांव आई डॉक्टर हेमंत कुमार साव ऑर्गेनाइजिंग सेक्रेटरी ऑफ दिस वेबिनार एक्सटेंड वेरी वार वेलकम टू आवर टूडेज चीफ गेस्ट डॉक्टर वी के पाठक सर रजिस्ट्रार बस्तर यूनिवर्सिटी बस्तर our keynote speaker sir and respected dear participants in the today's session of webinar on advances in pure and applied mathematics APAM I am feeling very much proud to welcome to our speaker of the session dr sudhir srivastav sir professor deen dayal upadhyay गोरखपुर यूनिवर्सिटी गोरखपुर उत्तर प्रदेश एंड आवर रिस्पेक्टेड स्पीकर डॉक्टर अब्राहम वर्गेश्वर यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी एंड अप्लाइड साइंस सल्तनेट ऑफ ओमान मस्कट थैंक यू सर फॉर ज्वाइन अस आई आल्सो वेलकम टू कन्वीनर डॉक्टर सपन खान मैडम एचओडी Department of Mathematics, Government Digvijay College, Rajnandgaon. Co-convener Dr. K.K. Devangan sir, Organizing Secretary Mrs. Kavita Sapre madam. I heartily welcome to all participants and thank you for participating actively. Our first day was very fruitful with the lots of discussions and interaction between participants and resource person. Now we are on the final day of webinar. We are very excited to see such a large number of viewers connected across the country to participate national webinar on advances in pure and applied mathematics APAM 2021. Now I would like to invite Mrs. Kavita Sapre madam for introduction of keynote speaker Sapre madam. Madam.
Very good afternoon to all of you. I, Kavita Sapre, am feeling honored to introduce Dr. Abraham Varghese sir. Dr. Abraham Varghese sir is working as faculty in IT department, University of Technology and Applied Sciences, Sultanate of Oman, Muscat. He received PhD degree in mathematics from Anna University, Chennai. He is reviewer of several international journals. He has authored more than 30 research articles and 2 books. He received research grant from Research Innovation Department for COVID-19. He received Surnanar Memorial Medal for academic excellence. He received intellectual property and artificial award for COVID-19 project from Oman Association. Now, may I request to Dr. Abraham Varghese sir for delivering his lecture on the topic fuzzy logic based decision making system for COVID-19 pandemic. Welcome to Abraham Varghese sir. Sir, please proceed, sir.
Varghese sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Let me share the screen. Good afternoon to everyone. Thank you again for the warm welcome, our Hemant sir and the madam. So today the presentation topic is fuzzy logic based decision system. The main objective of this presentation is how can we make use of fuzzy logic to solve a complex problem or real value problem, real world problem, how can be solved using the idea of the fuzzy logic. So in particular, the objective is, first I would like to introduce what is a fuzzy logic framework, then fuzzy modeling, what are the different components in a fuzzy modeling, then third part, how can we make fuzzy logic as a intelligent system by introducing neural network into it, and finally on a case study, a real time case study, to how to apply the intelligent fuzzy logic for that problem. This is the overall picture of the presentation. Now, as we all know, the real systems are very large and complex in nature, and modeling is one of the important to solve the tool to solve such system. Why? This is why, because modeling make the better understanding of the system, hence the system analysis. But the conventional method that have been used for modeling depends upon the mathematical tools which require precise information. But when we come to the reality, as the complexity increases, the precise knowledge is very difficult to get. Most of the systems are not precise, they are ill-defined. So in such cases, mathematical tool is not a good choice for solving such system. At that time, the soft computing technique will play a key role in solving such system. Even though we are not getting exact solution for that, we can get some approximate solution near to the accurate solution for that. So as this lofty Sade said, you can say he is known as the father of fuzzy logic. He died in the year 2017 at the age of 96. He said one important point: as the complexity of the system increases, our ability to make precise and significant statement about its behavior diminishes, and precision and significance becomes almost exclusive. Very, very important point. Here lies the beginning of the fuzzy logic. What he said is, precise and significance are mutually exclusive. They will not happen together. So whenever we give more importance to precise, we need to compromise for the significance. Whenever there is a problem where we are giving more importance to the significance, at that time we need to compromise for a precision. So that is the way, that is why the soft computing techniques are much more popular compared to hard computing now. Now, compared to this soft computing techniques, many methods are available there. Fuzzy logic is the one of the technique to solve the soft computing techniques. Let me get into this fuzzy logic, the basic ideas. What is a fuzzy logic? Most of us think that fuzzy logic is a fuzzy. It is not a fuzzy. It is a precise logic of imprecision and approximate reasoning. Whenever there is a vague idea or imprecision or ill-defined boundary, at that time we need to quantify that fuzzy logic can be used for that one. Human brain can reason with uncertainty. Say, if I say today is a very nice day, so human brain can easily judge that one. What is the meaning of nice? But if I say these words to the computer, computer cannot understand what is nice. The boy is very intelligent. What is intelligent? What is the meaning of intelligent? What is the meaning of very intelligent? The computer cannot understand that one. Computer perform very well for a deterministic input. If your input is deterministic one, accurate one, computer will perform better. But for this imprecision or partial truth or uncertainties, we cannot expect very good result from computer. At that time, this fuzzy logic will help us to combine these two. How can we make these vague ideas to a deterministic input? That is the main purpose behind this fuzzy logic. So fuzzy sets and fuzzy logic are powerful mathematical tools for modeling and controlling uncertain systems in industry, humanity, and nature. They are the facilitators for approximate reasoning in decision making in the absence of complete and precise information. That is the very important idea behind this fuzzy logic. Now, when we come to the history of this, Aristotle in the year 400 BC, he said, he has introduced law of bivalence. He said, every proposition is either true or false. If I say one statement, say sun rises in the east, the statement can be either true or false. It cannot be in between, and it cannot both true. Only true or false. If true happens, false will not happen. So every statement, 2 plus 2 is equal to 5, the statement is false. It cannot be true and false at the same time. This is the idea introduced by the Aristotle. But in 1900, Jahn proposed that there is one more logic is there. It can be possible also. Along with the true and false, we can have a statement which is possible also. In 1965, Loftier said, he introduced the idea of the fuzzy sets. He told, along with the 0 and 1, you can give any value in this range, 0 to 1, for a statement. I can give a 0.5, 0.7, 0.9, any value in the range 0 and 1. Aristotle taught only 0 and 1. True means 1, false means 0. We cannot give any value in between 0 and 1. But he told in 1965, it is possible to give the value between 0 and 1. I'll give some example later. So in 1975, he proposed the idea of fuzzy logic. Now it becomes a standard technology and applies in almost all fields. Plenty of application we can find fuzzy logic in the real-time industry. Now let me give some example where the classical logic is not enough. That means true or false. You see, you can see the statement, all people in this hall tell lie. Is Geeta also present here? Now my question is, does she speak true or false? If I say she speaks truth, but what is the statement? All people in the hall tell lie. That means that contradicts it. Again, if I say that she speaks lie, at that time, again, by the statement given there, it contradicts the fact. That means this statement can be true and false at the same time. It is not true or false. Right? So classical logic says that only two. If true is there, false will not happen. But here we can say that this statement is partially true. Now, this is a classical example. You might have heard this one. There is a barber. So a man in a town advertises his services. I shave all and only those who do not shave themselves. So the statement is, does the barber shave himself? Is it true or false? Suppose I say the barber shaves himself means the statement says that the barber can shave only those do not shave themselves. Therefore, the barber cannot shave himself. Therefore, statement will be false. But if I say that the barber does not shave himself means those who do not shave themselves go to this barber. That means barber shave himself. That means this statement is true and false. It is not true or false. It can be true at the same time. It can be false also. Now, this is an example from optical illusion. Are you able to see this picture? My question is she young? So, I'm not giving much time for this one. See, here you can see two pictures. When you look at here, you can see that this side you can see that young lady, at the same time you can see that old woman also. That means if I say she is young means it can be true if I look at the young girl. It will be false if I look at the old woman. So that is the idea. Now, this is the classical example for a fuzzy logic, by where we apply classical logic to fuzzy logic. You can see a heap of grains are there. I remove one grain from a heap. Now I ask the question, if I remove one grain from the heap, still it will be a heap. It will not change. Again, I take another one. Like that, I take 100 one. Right? Still it will be a heap. After taking finite number of repetition, finally what will happen? We are left with a few grains that is not a heap. Now the question is, when does the heap become a not a heap? Classical logic will not give the answer to this. Can we say that after taking 500 grains, the heap will not be a heap? It is not possible. If I say 500 means what about 499? What about 501? It's not possible. But using the fuzzy logic concept, we can say we can give some value to each and everything. We call it as a membership function. Using some membership value in the range 0 to 1, we can give each and every value to this the number of grains. We can say, after taking 500, we can say it is a heap with the membership function 0.7. That means 70% chance that it is a heap. Or after taking 100, I can say the membership function to become a heap is 0.3. That means 30% chance. Like that, at each and every moment, we can make some valid argument on whether this heap is a heap or not. Like that, we can give the argument. So that is the idea. But classical logic will not help us to do this. Another example you can see here. Can we distinguish red and green from this? If I take the left side and the right side, you can see left side is green, right side is red. I can easily distinguish. I can say left side is 100% green, right side is 100% red. But when you look at the middle value, what we can see that I cannot distinguish between that middle value. It can be partially green and partially red. So I can say that it is a 50% green and 50% red, or 0.6 red, 0.4 green. Like that we can think. Therefore, here also we cannot say using the classical logic, we cannot distinguish this red and green from there when you go to the middle part. So, in conclusion, there are many situations where we need to represent the notion like large, high, tall, wealthy, moderate, high to some extent, not quite high, very high. So, all such notions have unsharp boundaries. The boundaries are not well defined. It is ill defined. So at that time, we can use the fuzzy logic to model that. Therefore, in reality, the fuzzy logic will help us to model imprecision, uncertainty, and vagueness to solve such a problem. So this is the idea behind why we go for a fuzzy logic. Now, but slowly I move to the definitions. As you know, the classical difference between classical set and fuzzy set. Classical set will have a sharp boundary. So in this left side example, you can see that the boundary is sharp. When I say the element X is does not belong to the set A. At the same time, you can say Y is belong to that, fully belong to that. But when you look at the set B, you can say that Z is fully belong to that. But what about T? T is partially belong to that. So I can say that the 50% chance or 0.6 chance to become a member of that one. So partially belong to that. So one is a classical set, conventional set, there boundary is well defined. I can say that two things are there, whether it belongs to this, that, or does not belong. But in the case each and every element, we can say some the membership function for that. So that is the difference between classical set and fuzzy set. I'll give another example. You can see here the set of people that can run a mile in 4 minutes. Clearly written, set of people that can run a mile in 4 minutes or less. So it is a classical set. But if I say the set of faster runners, what is the meaning of fast? It is a fuzzy set. So we can, such a type of the imprecision idea, we can model it. Now, when we come to the formal definition of classical set and the fuzzy set, what you can say? In fuzzy set is described by using a characteristic function and is defined as it is equal to 1 when x is belong to the set A, and it is equal to 0 when does not belong to the set A. That's all, 0 and 1. But in the case of a fuzzy set, 0 and 1 is also there. If it is fully belong to that set, we say it is 1. Does not belong to that set, we say it is 0. In addition to that, we can say 0 between 0 to 1 is also possible. That means membership function, we call it as a membership function, can be a value in the range 0 to 1. That is also possible for us. So you can see here in classical set theory, we have only 0 and 1. In the bottom side, you can see we can have the degree of membership function from 0 to 1. We can grade it properly. We can grade it. So using the idea of the fuzzy set theory. Now this example will show the importance of fuzzy set. My problem is I want to distinguish between short, average, and tall. I take the height of the students and I want to classify short, average, and tall. If I am applying the classical set, what I can say, I need to define a sharp boundary. You can see here, between less than 170, it is short. Less than 170, it is short. Right? Between 170 to 180, you can say it is average. And above 180, it is tall. Like that only I can say. So what about a student is having 179 height? According to our CRISP set, the student belongs to the average. But when you define using fuzzy set, we can give a more clarity on it. The 179 is more closer to tall. So 179, it belongs to average. At the same time, it belongs to the tall also. Therefore, I can say 179 has a membership function 0.3 with the tall people. So what is the meaning of that one? Whenever I consider the tall people, the membership function of this student who belongs to that group is 0.3, 30% chance. But when I take the average people, there will be 0.7 chance. So like that, we can have a clear picture on each and every the linguistic variable that we are using here. So this will be more proper compared to the CRISP set. When we talk about the operation in a classical set, we can have intersection. What all operation that we are defining the classical set, same operation can be defined in the fuzzy set also. So A intersection B is a common region between A and B. But when we come to the fuzzy set, we take the, using the membership function, we take the minimum of that. Minimum of the first membership function of the set A and set B. So, and A union B, we know that it is the maximum value. Maximum value means the set belongs to either A or B. In the fuzzy set, what we do, we take the maximum value. So union is maximum of the membership function, and intersection means it is the minimum of the values. And complement also, complement function as usual, complement function of a characteristic function is 1 minus XA. Now you see this example, how we are solving the question using the fuzzy logic. There is one example. You can see this. Will wants to fly to California, and he wants to be inexpensive and not take a long time. So he want to choose a flight which is cheap and very fast. Then he look at the different choices of the flight. So he got three flight available, and he find what are the possibility. The expensive means 0.89. First flight will be expensive, 0.89. QQ means 0.95. And second flight is chance for expensive is 0.75, and fast is 0.65. What is the meaning of this one? If I say the second flight has fast is 0.65, means if I take all flight in that one, the flight B will be fast is 65% chance among all flight. That is the meaning. C will be 0.5555, and Q means 0.40. What I want to find? I want to find the flight. It is inexpensive. That is complement of expensive. So what is the complement of expensive? I find E complement. So when I find the E complement, first become 0.11, and B becomes 0.25, and C become 0.45. So what I do? I find E complement intersection Q. Intersection, already I told you, it is a minimum value. So we find the minimum value. So you can see the last column, 0.11, 0.25 and 0.40. Therefore, which flight he will choose? So he can choose the flight C, because flight C will have a higher value compared to this. So like that, he can solve this question. So he can choose the flight C for his purpose. Another example also there, I'm not going to explain this now. Now see this case. We can solve complex problem also using fuzzy. So set of students are sitting there. You can see the picture. I want to get a student with a green shirt and blonde hair. Blonde hair means yellow, yellowish color. So when you look at here, you can see two. One girl is there, one boy is also there, but their green is different. But when you apply the classical set, how can we solve this type of the question? So what I can choose is either he will choose the girl or it will choose the boy. But in fuzzy, using fuzzy set, we can give more clarity on it. What we do? We give the membership function. We define green color should be high, so it will be 0.95, that is this girl. This girl is having green color 0.95 compared to the boy. The green is much more better in this. And the air color is also here. So here the membership function is 0.87 and here it is 0.95. But when you look at the boy, you can see that it is 0.55 and 0.05. In this, using this idea, I can find. So I can use the proper person from this. So even though there are mixture of complex idea there, we can get the clarity on particular item on it. So that is the idea given that. I told you in the fuzzy logic, what we do, we represent using some membership function. At that time, this idea will be very useful. Whenever we want to say a little, at that time what we do, membership mu ax is a membership function, power 1.3 a little, whenever you want to represent. Slightly means membership function power 1.7. very means square. Extremely means power 3. Say whenever previously I showed one example, at that time depending upon our question we can choose more clarity on this. Head. Now, very, very means power 4. More or less means, say, many times we come across this type of the words, more or less same. At that, how to represent more or less same? In how can we quantify that? So we can say square root of the membership function, mu of x. Somewhat, that is also this. Indeed. So like that, we can represent. Now I told you the membership function is one of the very, very important point in representing the fuzzy set. So fuzziness is characterized by a membership function. So that there are different ways in which we can represent a membership function. Various type of the membership functions are there. One is triangular membership function, trapezoidal, S-shaped, Z-shaped, Gaussian, pi function, vicinity function. Depending upon our application, we can choose the proper one. So here, this is a triangular membership function. In triangular membership function is defined as when x is smaller than a, it will be zero. Completely zero, right? But when it lies between a and b, you can give a value in the range 0 to 1. 0 to 1, you can give the value in the range. Let me open this one yet. I want to write also, see. So I explain all this. So in the membership function, see, between, if it is between A and B, you can give any value. Say, for example, suppose 30. So 30 is somewhere here. I want to find the membership value for 30. How can you? Corresponding this, there will be a value here. You can see that this is a value corresponding to that. How can you find? Using this equation. What is the equation for that one? So X minus A, this is the value of X. X is here 30, so it will be 30 minus A. A is our 10, divided by B minus A. B minus A is the full value. B is 50, 50 minus 10. So it will be 20 divided by 40. So you can say 0.5. That means the membership value for the number 30 is 0.5. So we are using the triangular membership function. Same way, suppose you want to find the value 60, corresponding to 60. The membership function will be somewhere here. I can find a value somewhere here. That means in this case, if it is greater than B, I can use this result, that is C minus X by C minus B. C is the final value. So what is the final value? Maybe this is 90. So I can say 90 minus 60 divided by the C minus B. C is 90, B is 50. So 90 minus 50. So I can say 30 divided by 40. Around say 0.75. Therefore, the number, the membership function correspond to 60 is this. That means any value if you give in this range, we can give the membership function. But if it is more than 90, 0, less than 10, it will be 0. So all function, all we can, all linguistic variable, we can fuzzify using this. This is a triangular membership function. Like that, we can have a trapezoidal. So this idea is, whenever you have a problem, we identify what are the input for this. This input we need to fuzzify. That means we need to assign a value in the range 0 to 1. At that time, we use this type of the membership function. Depending upon our application, either you can use triangular or trapezoidal. If it is a trapezoidal, if it is less than A, it will be 0 here. Less than A, it will be 0. Between A and B, we choose this. And B to C, it will be 1, and C to D, this. So suppose you want to represent in 4 different ways, at that time you can use this one. If you want to represent in a smooth curve, you can go for a S-shaped one. The equation is this. Or Z shape, you can go for. Usually we apply this Gaussian membership function because it is differentiable also. This function is very smooth. Every point you can find the derivative. Therefore, Gaussian membership function, somewhat it is normal also. Pi function, vicinity function. So these are the different the membership function. Now the next question is, how can we assign the membership function? What are the different methods for assigning a membership function? You can use one of this method. Either we can use intuition. Intuition means human intelligence. We study, as a human, we study the problem and we can assign. So this range, tall means, okay, above 170. So this is our human intelligence, intuition, inferences, rank ordering, all this. Neural networks also can apply, genetic algorithms. So these are the methods that can be used for assigning membership function automatically. No need for a human interface in that one. Without a human, we can find the membership function using this neural network or genetic algorithm. Or if you apply the intuition and inferences and rank ordering means human intelligence. We only find the problem and accordingly we find it. So this is the first part. Now I'll slowly move to the fuzzy model. So first part, just I introduce what is a fuzzy logic. Why we go for a fuzzy logic? In fuzzy logic, what are the important components? One important components I explain: membership function. Membership using membership function, we fuzzify the input value, right? And what are the different type of the membership function also I explained, and what are the different method to give this assign the membership function there. That theory part I can go through later, that what are the different methods using there. Now, the fuzzy modeling, this is important. Whenever there is a problem there, how can we apply the fuzzy modeling to solve that one? The idea is this. So our input is crisp one. This input we fuzzify. That means we convert in the range 0 to 1 using membership function. After that, this membership function, we combine using rules. This rules also generated by human also. Either human can generate or automatically we can generate from the data also. That also we can do. Then what we do, so after the combining rules, this will be a fuzzy value only. This fuzzy value we need to convert to crisp value so that we apply the defuzzification. These are the four steps that we are applying for the fuzzy modeling for any problem. So whenever there is a input output mapping is there, you can go for a fuzzy modeling. And these are the three different models that commonly using. One is called a Mamdani modeling, Sugino modeling, Sugamoto modeling. So whenever we refer for a fuzzy modeling, that time I will choose one among this. I'll give a quick review on this. And I will show an example also. So again, for developing a fuzzy logic controller or fuzzy modeling, the basic step is the input will be given, output will be also given. Input output will be given. So we need to find the linguistic variable for this. So this in linguistic variable, we assign some linguistic value for this. So for example, suppose you want to find the mark of a student, at that time the grade will be the linguistic variable. And what are the linguistic values? Fail, poor, good, very good, excellent. These are the linguistic values. So all the input, we find the corresponding linguistic variable and linguistic value also. So whenever we talk about furnace, the temperature will be the linguistic variable. Cold, warm, hot, this will be the linguistic values. Now, the basic structure of this fuzzy system is this. We have one input. Input will be given. So we fuzzify that. You'll get a membership function. In that, we pass this membership function to the inference engine using the rules. This is a fuzzy rule. After fuzzy rule, we combine. Then we defuzzify and we get the output. So this output is also a crisp value. Input also a crisp. Finally, the output is also a crisp value. So these are the different steps for this one. In the Mamdani model, this is a simple model. It is introduced by John Mamdani in the year 1975. So he introduced this one for solving the question. for a steam engine and boiler combination problem. He made some rules and he solved the problems of this one. Now it is a quite common, this one, very simple model also there. It works on this principle. The rule will be like this. If X is A1 and Y is B1, we have a two input and we are assigning the linguistic variable for this. If X is A1 and Y is B1, the output will be Z1. So this A1, B1 and C1 we specified using the membership function. Then finally we combine and we make as the CRISP value. So the steps are specification, rule evaluation, aggregation of the rule, then finally defuzzification. So this is the method for the Mamdani. Sugno is also working in the same manner with a small difference. In the Sugno, the output will not be any constant value. It will be a linear function. Either it can be first order or constant or a linear function. P1x plus Q1y plus R1. Here this P1, Q1 and R1 are called the parameters. So our aim is to find these parameters. P1, Q1 and R1, P2, Q2 and R2. These parameters we need to find. But in the Sugamoto FI, the fuzzy inference system, here also the output will be C1 and C2. Here it is a monotonic. That's only the difference. In the Mamdani, it is not a monotonic. Here it will be a monotonic function. Now I'll explain with one example. I take this example because this is quite common. Everyone can understand this. My problem is, I want to grade the student. What are the input? His GRE and GPA is given. So GRE score is given and GPA is given there. So I have a two input. So one is GRE and another one is GPA. Grade point average and GRE is there. This mark is given and final output should be one decision I want to make. Decision on what? Decision on the intelligent level of a student. Whether the student is good. So these are the classification I want. Whether it is excellent, very good, good, fair and poor. So input is 2, output is 1. So this is a 2 input, 1 output problem. So what is the first step? Based on GRE and GPA, we need to fuzzify it. How can we fuzzify it? Using the linguistic variable. Using linguistic variable, we fuzzify it. Then we need to make a rule. Finally, this rule will be combined using defuzzified methods. Then it converts to the final output. So how can we fuzzify it? You can see here, the first value is your GRE. So GRE, I make some linguistic variable here. What are the linguistic variable here? Low, medium and high are the values using this one. How can we assign? Using our intelligence. Say we combine what we find, what is the maximum value, what is the minimum value. And here you can see if it is less than 800, if the student's GRE is less than 800, fully belongs to low. But if it is between 800 and 1200, you cannot say that it is fully belong to low, but you can give some value for this. Some value can be given here. Same way, if it is 800 to 1600, you can give some value for the medium also. Using this, you can define the membership function. For example, suppose the student got the mark 1300. So how can we give the membership value? So if 300 means what about the low? There is no, the membership function for the low is 0 because up to 1200 only we define low. But 1300 is somewhere here. So when you draw a line here, you can see that when you draw a line here, it belongs to high or medium. So what about the membership function in the medium? So you find this value. This is the median value. So what is the highest value here? So I calculate 1600 minus, I want to find 1300 divided by what about that range? Range is 400. That means 300 divided by 400. So we can say 0.75. That means if the students get the mark 1300, is membership function in medium is 0.75. Similarly, what about the high value membership function? The high value will be somewhere here. So here, so we calculate that 1300 minus 1200 divided by 400. That means 0.25. Like that, we can calculate the membership value for this one. Same way, we calculate the GPA for also the membership function also, same for GPA also. After that, what we do, we output also, we membership function, output function also, we do that one. So falsification done. Once the falsification is done, we give the rule. What is the rule? This rule also we are doing. When the GRE is high, GPA is high, the student is excellent. When GRE is medium, GPA is high, student is very good. When GRE is low and GPA is high, it will be fair. Like that, we can make here, we can apply the our human intelligence. So using this, what we do, we can find the membership value here. We combine here, HH means high and high. So when we combine high and high, 0.25 and 0.75, we are combining using AND operator. AND means we find the minimum value. So minimum value is 0.25. Like that, we can combine, we can find the value. So this is the rule. After this rule, what we do? We can have the interpretation there. So how many good values are there? Two good values are there. When you find the, when you combine, you will get a 0.25. And very good is 0.75. Therefore, if a student get 1300, so he belongs to very good, good, and there is no membership function for fair and poor, right? Now what we do finally, we defalsify this one and we get a one value, we convert to that value in a CRISP value, we'll get a 83.5. We check what about this 83.5 in our output, and we can say that the student is a good student. So if you give any value in this range, we can have a grade. So what happens to our usual grading system? Suppose a student get more than 80, so we classify him as a distinction. More than 80, it is a distinction. What about 79? The student is first class, but there is not much difference between 79, 80 in their intelligence level. So we give a sharp boundary there. 79 means first class, 80 means distinction. But intelligent level, they are more or less same. But using fuzzy, we can say 79 also belongs to distinction with the lower member of lower degree of membership. 80 also distinction. Like that, we can give a classification for each and every point. Right? We can give the grading, relative grading also using this idea. I will show you how it works. Whether time is there, I can show that how it's work using some coding easily. I can show you. Okay, let me check. Are you able to see? So here, so this is what the grading what we modeled. So you can see here, I hope you can see, there is a one GRE and GPA is there, two input and one output, decision is there. So input two in, this is a Mamdani model. You can see here, I have written here Mamdani model. So two input and one output. So this input, I just apply the falsify rule, and you can see that what membership function is assigned. Low will be up to 1200 and medium will be 800 to this one, and high will be 1200 to high, like this. like that GPA also be defined properly. We define everything. Now what we do, you can see the rule also. The rule will be this. So you can see the rule. Yeah, these are the 9 rule we have. You say GR is high, GPA is medium, then decision is good. Like that, we can define the the rule. Now you see the what about the result? So I combine this, and you can see the result here. Here you can see. You give any GRE and GPA, the decision you can see on the right side. Suppose I give the value, say 1300 for a 1300 for GPA, sorry GRE, and 3.2 for GPA. What about the result? You can see decision is 83.5. Continuously, you can give any mark there. It will calculate the grading of the student. Either it is a good, very good, etc. So I can change this one. Any value I can give accordingly, a GA or GPA, it will be changed. And you can see this one on the surface also, you can see that one. This is another method of seeing the output. You can see this output also. See, here you can see that when the grade is GRE and GPA is low, the decision will be very low. That means more or less same. But when GRE is high and GPA is very high, it will go up. So you can see here, when GRE is there, how the GRE and output is connected. When GRE is moving to 200, the decision becomes very high. That means it becomes excellent. Similarly, GPA is also there. When the GPA is high, it will go to up. So like that, we can make the system perfect. Okay, let me go to our original one. So I hope you can see now. Model fuzzy using a real-time example for grading the student. That also we explained. Now we slowly move to the neuro-fuzzy approach. How can we integrate? How can we give the intelligence to the fuzzy? That is the idea. So here, what we do? Two things we are doing. So what is the drawback for the fuzzy logic? The drawback for the fuzzy logic is we can represent the ill-defined or imprecise information using fuzzy logic, but it has no learning capability. In the fuzzy logic, what all things we tell, say for grading, we need to assign this, we need to assign the membership function, we need to give the linguistic value, we need to define the rule, everything. there is no learning capability. It has no ability itself. But when you look at the neural network is very good for learning. So what we do, we combine both neural network and fuzzy logic so that we can make a intelligent system. And this intelligent system, we call it as a neuro-fuzzy system. Nowadays, you can see plenty of applications. Many of the people are working on this neuro-fuzzy system. Okay. So what is the idea of this one? We call it as a adaptive neuro-fuzzy system where we are using Takagi-Sugino model for this one. And the adaptive neuro-fuzzy system, it is introduced in the year 1993. And it is functionally same as, it is functionally same as Takagi-Sugino type inference model. Yeah, make a fuzzy inference system using Mamdani model also, but adaptive neural fuzzy inference system, it is based on the Takagi-Sugino type model. And here, ANFIS is given the ability to learn from training data. And this is a hybrid intelligent system. Fuzzy logic is not an intelligent system, but this is an intelligent system that take the advantage of both AN and fuzzy logic theory. Both we can apply, right? And here the training takes place using the least square method and the gradient descent method. So I told you in the fuzzification also, we need to set some parameter, and output also we need to set some parameter. For that, for setting the parameter, we are using the least square method and gradient descent method. Okay. Now, this is the basic structure of adaptive neuro-fuzzy inference system, basic structure of this one. Here you have a five layer, layer 1, layer 2, layer 3, layer 4, and layer 5. Five layers are there. In the layer 1, what we do the fuzzy. Fuzzification will be done in the layer 1. Here the membership functions are assigned. And once the membership functions are assigned, the output will be, here you can see the output. So this output will be in the range 0 to 1, right? And here I have given two membership values. Say for example, suppose this is GRE and this is GPA. The membership function will be low, medium and high, but I have used only two here, low, medium. Will be one value here, and here also one value, here also four value will be there. So we need to combine. How to combine? We take the pi. Pi means product. So in the layer 2, what we do, we take the product of the membership function of mu 1 into mu 1 of x into mu 3 of y. That means for combining that one, if grade GRE is low and GPA is low, whatever the output. So we need to combine one from here and one from here. Therefore, total how many rules will be there? Four rules will be there. So after finding the layer 2, what we do, we normalize this one. So W1, we find W2. In here, we need to normalize. How to normalize? So W1 bar will be equal to W1 divided by W1 plus W2. After normalizing, go to layer 4. In this layer 4, we are giving the value, we multiply this W with our F value. What is F? F is a Takagi model where it will be P1X plus Q1Y plus R1. This value we are giving here, P1, Q1, R1 we need to find. So for that, we are applying the help of the neural network. So after getting this one, we combine and you get a one value. Final output will be like this. Now we'll check the, what about this error in that one? Say whenever there is an input-output mapping, so output will be there. We compare this output with this. If there is an error here, this value we move, give it to here. Accordingly, the membership function modify. And this value we give to the parameter also there. That means that training takes place. Till we get a satisfied output, this process will continue. That's why it is called an intelligent system. Human interference is very less. So we need to set properly what about the input, what about the output. the system will generate and we can get the model. I'll show you how it works. Okay. So this is the main idea of the ANFIS. You can go through this one, adapting your fuzzy system. Whenever you have the practical application, you have some problem. And if that problem is some input-output mapping, you have an input, valid input, and you know the outputs are there. And the number of input is very less, you can always go for adapting your fuzzy system. There, the system itself generate the intelligent system for you by training the system. Okay, I'll explain how it works. All the five layer, I'll explain, then I'll show the example for that one. So in the ANFIS layer one, I told you here membership function will be assigned. So we get a membership function here. That is the first two part. For assigning this membership function, either you can go for some method already explained, or in the ANFIS there are some method is that grid partition. This is a one method. Subtractive clustering is there. This is another method. And another method is fuzzy cmins. You see this method, you can fuzzify the input. That is the first part. In the layer two, what I told you, we take the product of this membership function. That is the product of this one. And layer three, we normalize. Layer three, what we do, we normalize this one. You can see W1 equal to W1 plus W1 by W1 plus 2. In the fourth layer, what we do, we multiply with this function. This is a Takagi-Sugino model. So we apply the fuzzy logic model and combine with the neural network. You can see. And this we hear. And the fifth layer, what we do, we find the final output. After getting this output, you can see, when you see the structure, there are some square node and there are some circle also there. Circular node is there, square node is there. Square node means you can improve it, you can fine tune it. That means membership function can fine tune. And this value P1, Q1, R1, so you can fine tune using your training data, input, output data, you can do that. That is the idea. So one example I am showing here, see here, this is how it works. You can see that I have taken two input. I apply the membership functions. Let it be 0.5 membership function. Here it will be 0.1. And here it is 0.5. I combine. I take the product of this 0.5 into 0.5. It will be 0.25. Here 0.1 into 0.39. It will be this. Then I normalize. How to normalize? 0.025 plus W1 plus W2. I get this value. I multiply this with the Takagi-Sugino model. I'll get a final output, and this will be 2.0197. Suppose this is actually the output. Suppose the target value is say 2.1, then you can say that there will be some error. That is, error is TSO. This is the error. So suppose you see that if the error is okay, you can leave it. You can accept the model. But if the error is, you cannot accept that, what do you do? This input we modify here. Membership function we modify, parameter we modify, again we run. Again we check the output, whether it is output, the difference is less. So this process will continue till you get a satisfied output. This is a method how it works. And the limitation of ANFIS is it is computationally cost. Why? Because depending upon the number of, as the number of input increases, rule will also increases. At that time, it will be complex. Otherwise, if it is a smaller number of input output mapping, you can always go for this ANFIS method. Plenty of application, I'm not going to go through all these things. There are application in medical field, defense, transportation, robotics, securities. We can make a decision system. We can make a decision system for security trading. And business, electronics, financial, industrial, chemical industry, so many applications, optimization, manufacturing, marine, mining, and it can be used in networks and intrusion detection system. You can apply, and you can apply in image processing. You can apply for even for optimization also. You might have studied some optimization technique. Fuzzy logic can also be applied in optimization. So this is the idea on the fuzzy logic. How much time left, sir?
Yeah, Abraham, sir.
So can I get how much time left, sir?
10 minutes, sir. 10.
Okay. So I conclude now. I'll show one case study. So far, whatever things I discussed, one is introduction to fuzzy logic. Introduction to fuzzy logic. What are the components in fuzzy logic, especially the membership function that I explained. After that, first modeling. Three different models are there: Mamdani, Takagi Sugino, and Sugimoto models. Basic structure of a fuzzy modeling that also I explain with one real time example how to make a model, fuzzy model, for grading the student intelligence level, whether it is excellent or poor, very good, etc. That was the first and second part. The third part, how can we give intelligence to the fuzzy logic? That was the idea. So what I do, I combine fuzzy logic numeral network, and I call it as ANFIS, adaptive neurofuzzy inference system, and explain the structure of that one. But when you go to the detail, you have to, it will take time, some time to go through this one, how it works. I just give the overall idea about how the ANFIS five layer, each layer, what will happen. This now I'll explain with a case study how ANFIS work for this problem. And this work we have done last year, and we have got the project from the government of Oman, and we have done this work, and this work is published in Elsevier, in a SA Index journal. And the idea is, last year, you know, in the pandemic, so many people are suffering from that one. The hospitals also, there are a scarcity of the ICUs there. At that time, but we approached the hospital, and we have made some type with the hospital. They have given the data of the patient who admitted 6 months. So we collected out of this, we make a model for that. And this model they are using in the hospital, we have given. I'll show you that model also. And here the idea is that once a patient is there in the hospital, is there any need to admit the patient in ICU or not by analyzing the medical history? So we have collected some data, and from the hospital they have given demographic details, medical details, what are the different symptoms, how many times, how many days they are admitted in the hospital, all these details they have given. So based on this, we have made a model for this one. So total, when we get the data, so total there will be 57 parameters are there, one by one. So we analyze one by one that parameter, and finally we reached at 8 potential parameters for that one. These are the significant, actually we showed that one, these are the significant variable to consider them in ICU, whether the particular patient needed to admit in ICU or not. Sometimes no need to ICU. So here, what are the different the values? One is the hospitalization period, and we find the what is the odd ratio. Odd ratio is one. This is a crucial one, like that. And absolute lymphocyte count, and C-reactive protein, then LDH, Kerb score. Kerb score is the actually the confusion, urea, respiratory, blood pressure. There will be one score is there between 0 to 5, one score will be there. So here that point, the score also very crucial because it is odd ratio is 2.66. And shortness of breath, you know that one. So one of the importance that we observe is shortness of breath in the COVID-19 pandemic. and X-ray variation. So in that one, you can see X-ray variation is also very important because odd ratio is 6.33, 3.9, etc. So these eight, and we apply some machine learning model, and machine learning model, and we have score. In that score, if it is between zero, it will show a number 0 to 5. If it is 5, definitely that a patient needed to admit in the ICU or not. If it is 1 or 2, no need to admit in the ICU or not. So I will show that one. So this one I have is also the adaptive neurofuzzy I applied. How? Using adaptive neurofuzzy to model this problem. Whether can we find a system, can we make a model to determine whether a patient is admitted in ICU or not. So here input is there, output is there. What is the input? These 8 parameters, 1, 2, 3, 4, 8 parameters I give to my model. What is the output? Output will give a one number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sometimes 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. If it is around 5, we will suggest that definitely this patient needed to admit in the ICU. Otherwise, no need. So here it is a gradual. So no sharp boundary. So here also hospitalization period, that is the sharp boundary for 14, 13 like this. But other values are continuous value. You can give a membership function for each and every this value. Make a rule for this one. Make a system and a final output. Here fuzzy logic itself is not enough. Why? Because it is very difficult. 8 parameters means how can I make a rule for this one? So what I do? I apply neural network on this one, and we call it as a adaptive neurofuzzy model. I will show how it works. Next 5 to 10 minutes, I will show this one, and after that, I'll conclude it. Okay, now I'll show this one. Are you able to talk? You can see the screen. Just I'll explain this one. This was the problem. What is the likelihood of ICU admission? That was so we collected after taking ethical approval, because data is very, very important. You know, all models are wrong. Some models are useful, and accuracy of any model depends upon the quality of data. If your data is not proper, what all model you are making, no use. Therefore, first very important thing, make sure that your data is perfect. So what we have done, we asked some doctors from the hospital and asked them to verify it. From them only we have taken the data. So that's why for that we have taken some ethical approval, and not any data downloaded from the net. No, direct we went to the hospital, taken the data, and then we have done. Then first we have made the statistical analysis. These are the demographic details. I think you can see properly. Mainly the demographic details, medical history, symptoms, and the laboratory observations. So from this, I told you, we identified 8 parameters statistically using lasso operator in the statistics. We identify that these parameters are very crucial, potential parameters. So what we do in this ANFIS model, you can see here, I have taken 385 data. You can see this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is a 385 patient data. Right side, you can see here each parameter. So you can see here, one is hospitalization period. For example, first patient, how many days he spent in the hospital? Only 4 days. And what about the alpha symphyte count, CRP, LDH, each, everything we find. Finally, what about the output? Output is 1. Output is 1 means no need to admit in the hospital. Like that, we have taken. Now, I have 8 input and 1 output. I want to make a model. That is my aim. So, I apply adaptive neurofuzzy system. In the adaptive neurofuzzy system, what I do? First, I load the input. You can see here, let me run this one. So this is actually the neurofuzzy designer. I hope you can see. This is a neurofuzzy designer done using MATLAB. and here you can give the training. I have given, so total 385 data is with me. 60% I have given for training and 20% for testing and 20% for the checking. So what I do, testing data I upload here. So here the testing data. So train. So I added this data here. Okay, I'll show from here. Yeah, you can see here, this one, this is the training and testing and checking has been done here. Then after running this one, you can see the output here. Say the training data and error, you can see here. The root mean square value, we found that one. And the result also you can see. And for the testing training, and I can see the coefficient of determination R value, R square value is 95 for 98% for training and 95% for the testing data is there. Okay. Now, this is the model we generated out of this. I told you we have 8 parameters, and this 8 parameter we give as an input there. So it will generate one output. So hospitalization period, let me give some value, say 13 here. And this value say 0.7. And C reactive protein, so 87.3. LDH value around 93. Some value I'm giving, but it should be in the proper range. Otherwise, it won't give the correct answer. The curb score around say 3. And there is any significant? No. So experience shortness of breath, yes, it was there. And chest X-ray variation, that is also there. So what we do, we calculate the score. So you can see that the patient belongs to high risk group with a 94.8%. Definitely this patient needed to admit in the ICU. So this model, now they are using this model we have given to the hospital, and now they are using this model for their, after getting analyzing this one, the doctors can take the decision on this. So now I conclude. See, so as a conclusion, so today I explain what is a fuzzy logic. Fuzzy logic is used to quantify imprecise and vague information with the help of a membership function. This part explained. And a fuzzy modeling also explained. Then after that, neural network has the inherent capability to learn from the data. Therefore, what we do, we combine neural network and fuzzy logic together. We call it as a ANFIS. So, and it will work well where there is a proper input output mapping is there. You can always go for a ANFIS. And these are the references. This is the book which I referred for getting the basic details. And the second one is the paper which last year we published. It is online, it is available online. If you are interested, you can go through that, this paper. This is the basic model. In this model, we did using machine learning. Now I am trying to apply that ANFIS for this one. So better result we are getting that one. So model, we get a more accuracy on this one. So I